Ciao, bentornati. Welcome back to Pillole di Italiano. Today's episode, episode number 45, was inspired by a request that I received quite a lot in the past couple of weeks. So I decided to make an episode to get it out there as soon as possible. This episode is going to be centered around that word magari, that I'm sure every one of you heard somehow and probably cannot necessarily pinpoint it. What does that mean? How do we use it? Before we jump into today's episode, just a reminder to keep using the comment section below to, of course, let me know what you think about the specific episode that you just watched, but also ask those questions. Let me know about your doubts. I'm always more than happy to create little pillole to answer those questions. Let's keep the channels of communication open, and I'm always super, super happy to help you as much as I can making progress in your Italian journey. Speaking of, if by any chance you feel like, great, you're acquiring a lot of Italian, a lot of knowledge is building up, but you don't know where to put it, and you're having trouble finding someone to actually speak Italian with, just a reminder that I have two groups currently for conversations so that you can come and get your Italian juices flowing. I call them Aperitivo Italiano, and they take place on Thursdays at 6 p.m. Eastern Time and Fridays at noon. Always Eastern time since I live in New York. So feel free to come and join. I will put a link where you can get your ticket right down here in the description of the episode. If you have any question about those aperitivos and you're just wondering if those are the right kind of tool that you can use, I'm putting a link in the description of the episode that you could use to book a free consultation session with me so that I can help you out determine if the aperitivos are the right space for you. All right, let's talk about magari, shall we? Magari, what does that mean with Italian gesture? What the heck does that mean? Magari is a synonym of forse. You might be familiar with forse. So it basically means maybe. Most of the time, forse and magari are interchangeable. Forse andrò in spiaggia domani. Maybe I'll go to the beach tomorrow. Magari vado a fare una passeggiata più tardi. Maybe I'll go take a walk, I'll go for a walk later. I could have used forse instead of magari and vice versa in these two sentences. It doesn't really matter. Both forse and magari translate with maybe. So what's the issue, right? Why is that so tricky and why do we find magari in other sentences with verbs that sound a bit weird, such as magari potessi venire. Magari potessi venire. In this case, magari does not mean maybe. Maybe I could come. It actually means I wish I could come. Magari potessi, and that's why you find that congiuntivo, the subjunctive. I don't know if you're familiar with it. If you're not, let's just not dive into it right now. I don't want to overcomplicate this Italian pill for today. We're just going to stick with the meaning of magari. In this case, will mean I wish. And when it means I wish, then you need to use a subjunctive, but don't worry about it right now. So for today, let's only worry about distinguishing between the meaning of magari as a synonym of forse, therefore maybe, and the other meaning of magari, I wish. So one thing, if you're reading Italian, it's going to be easier because you will have more time to look at the verb, to look at punctuation. When magari means I wish, usually you have an exclamation mark. Magari, you could even use it by itself. Magari, I wish. Another hint will be to look at the verb that comes right after, or to, you know, if you're hearing someone speaking in Italian, to pay close attention to what follows that magari. Is the verb at the present or future, or is the verb in a weird form of the past? So present or future, that is your maybe. Maybe I'll go. Maybe I'll do. Maybe I am going to. I'm saying present and future because in Italian the present tense is often used to express the future. So maybe I will eat pizza tonight. You could say forse or magari. Magari mangerò la pizza stasera, or simply magari mangio la pizza stasera, because Italians use the present to express the future too. But if after magari you have the double S, that's a type of past, passato. If you want to link that word passato, that means past in Italian, has a double S, with the ending of these specific verbs. There you have it. So when you see magari with passato, then you are in the wish land. I wish. Magari potessi venire con te oggi. Magari potessi venire con te oggi. I wish I could come with you today, but maybe I have to work. Okay, I hope that this distinction between magari, when it means maybe, and magari when it means I wish, it's clear, at least when it comes to formulating statements. When you're saying, I wish I could, or maybe I will. What happens when you're asking a question and the person answers just with magari? How are we going to interpret that? Because there is no verb there associated to that answer. It's just that magari. So one hint would be the intonation. When someone says, I wish, the intonation is going to be a bit different, such as magari, magari, magari. You have different ways, slightly different ways. But it's not as flat as the maybe. Magari. I don't know if you can hear it. If you are communicating in writing, most likely the person who says, I wish, will put an exclamation mark afterwards. And hopefully for you, to ease you into the distinction between the two magaris and help you out, the person who says magari as a response will add something afterwards, such as if you're asking them, will you come with us this afternoon? They might say, magari, non lo so ancora. Magari, non lo so ancora. Maybe, I don't know it yet. Or if they want to say, I wish, but then they have something else to do, they might want to justify that. So they will not just say magari, but they will say, magari potessi. Se non dovessi lavorare, verrei. Magari potessi, right? I wish I could. So maybe they will grace you with that congiuntivo right after. Or even just saying magari, ma devo lavorare. So you see how they're giving you an explanation that goes against saying that they're free and they're available. When you hear that ma coming afterwards, that's another hint that they're wishing they could, but they cannot. Magari, ma devo lavorare. I wish, but I have to work. So hopefully this is not too confusing. To an Italian speaker, it's kind of obvious, and I hope that by practicing and by getting exposed to these two different types of magari, you will just develop an ear for it, in a sense. Well, in a literal sense, because you will hear the difference in intonation, and then you will start paying attention to the verb that usually comes right after. So is that a present or proper future, or is that a congiuntivo? I leave it at that. I hope that this is enough. If it's not, let me know. If you have more doubts, if this created somehow more confusion, please let me know. I will try to help you untangle. Leave a comment in the comment section below. Feel free to use that space also to practice or to let me know if you found examples of magari that do not add up. I will help you figure them out. That's it for today. Don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it, and I will see you soon. Ciao, a presto!